Suba Sandhyaga. Good evening to everybody. Mr. Pratap Balakrishnan, Manager Sri Lankan Airlines. Mr. Kumudu Fonseca, Chairman, and Mrs. Fonseca. Mrs. Hettige, the Principal. Mr. Sebastian, GM, Marcus Hotel. Members of the Board of Trustees, Vice Principal, teachers, parents, and students. It's nice to be in the sun. It's raining a lot in Sri Lanka. And I know that you would love the rain here. It's always green on the other side. But anyway, I would start my speech with a small note. When I saw the girl singing Amma Varune, it touched my heart. It touched my heart for a reason. I saw the girl's emotions. They were singing to their mothers. And I felt very sorry for my mother. Because I have two brothers, we have no sisters. But I could feel the relationship pain between a daughter and a mother. So that's why in school I was always dressed as the girl. My mother thought that I would be the daughter. And up to about age 13 I was always at the prize giving and all the other occasions I was dressed as a girl. I hated it, but she made sure that I was the girl. Anyway, it was a very tight schedule for me. I was trapped into actually coming to Doha. It's very difficult for me to, these were very hectic days for us. I was heavily involved in the COP on this bond issue. And then the budget is also now coming. Anyway, I'm delighted to be here. Take a little bit of rest and to see the normal world once in a way. And I have to thank Honorable Nalin Bandara actually for getting me here. He was not able to make it with us. He had a small problem with the visa. But anyway, I thank him for making me come. When I saw the students, when I saw the applause, Mr. Fonseca said, when you receive awards, the students are happy, teachers are happy, the parents are happy. It would be nice if all the other students also was here. Because I would say, even the principal quoted Nelson Mandela, and he said the importance of education. But education is not merely books and studying. If you take Nelson Mandela's life, he became a lawyer, he studied, that's true. But the best education he got in the prison. So for these students also, I think it's important to realize your studies are important. I'm not discouraging you. But life itself is education. And I saw another quote, I think in your song, in your school song, loyalty and honesty. Another important thing is standing up for principles, which we lack in this modern society. I have to disappoint the principal a bit when she said that I excel in my studies and my sports in school. It's not true. I was average. My brothers were very good. They always got about 5, 6, 7 awards. One became a chronic pain specialist in England. Another one became a financial controller for Baxter in the States. And I was called the stupid one in the family. It's true. My brother always called me more dad. But it was a training, as I said. That was education for me. And I failed a lot of times in my life. My mother was a lecturer, my father was a judge. But one thing I really admire in my parents, they didn't push me that much for studies. I learned all what I learned in the streets, playing with my friends, playing football, playing cricket, playing gudu, anything. That itself is a training and education. That a lot of parents don't realize this. A word of advice for the parents. My parents never pushed us on anything. They never came and checked us in our school. They never came and spoke to our teachers. I see some parents pursuing so much. Sometimes they make their children robotics. And I'll give you a good statistic actually about my friends and us. Education is always good. But the education that you learn from society is, I think, more important. You teach your children values, loyalty, honesty, and to stand up for principles. If you teach them these simple qualities, I'll assure you, they'll be very successful in the societies. If I take my friends from school, and that's why I said that if the other students were also here, that would have been nice. We are working hard, as you know, as a country, as a government. Within the first year, having a minority government, we brought in 9 commissions, independent commissions, so the politicians won't interfere with the civil service, and the Information Act. People might not even feel these things, but we have brought good governance, democracy, rule of law, transparency. Anybody can criticize the president or the prime minister. And we get criticized too often, actually. People forget that they have the right to criticize because we have given that freedom to our nation and our country. But we are proud of it. Because we have put a lovely foundation, a solid foundation for our country. And on that foundation, with my ministry, we are trying to sign 3 fitted agreements, one with India, China, Singapore, and then develop Hamathura port, Trincomalee port, and the Colombo port. Make Sri Lanka the gateway to South Asia. When you have those agreements, half the population of the world would be our market. 50,000 acre industrial zone in Hambantota. Electric cars will be made there. Electric motor bicycles will be made there. We are trying to have incubations and to have startup companies, 2,500 new, brand new exporters. We have to move into new industries. We can't develop on perennial industries. If you take Japan, they developed around few companies, Honda, Yamaha, Mitsubishi, Nissan Sunny, Sony. Last 50 years they developed these companies. And if you take Korea, Samsung, LG. Last 20 years they developed these new industries. So Sri Lanka is also on the verge of moving into that development. So that your hard work, your sacrifice, we can bring you back to this lovely country. And what you invest on your children, we want to make it a reality for you back home, probably in about 5 or 10 years' time. We want you to have the same opportunities that you have here, even better. And it's a tipping point for Sri Lanka. And let me rest assured that we are on the right path. And once again, let me commend you all. Coming to a foreign country, and especially the chairman and the board of trustees, you all have done a wonderful job having this institution and all these children and all the parents. You have made us proud back in Sri Lanka. And a lovely applause to all of you all who's here. Have given back to your country while staying in a foreign country. And I hope the children who won awards will be encouraged, and the parents as well, and the other children. The majority haven't won awards, but go and tell them that they will also have a chance in the future, probably during their school career or even after. And thank you very much for having me here, the warmth you all showed me, and the great work you all do here. It gives us courage, it gives us inspiration as a government for us to do better. Thank you very much. Have a good evening.